When it comes to exercise, there are always people who try and go and do things so differently that it creates a trend that people want to copy. A great example of this is yoga. At its core, yoga is a very simple yet elegant thing that allows people to stretch their bodies and also their minds in a way that hard exercise doesn't always do. So naturally, some people came along and decided to add to it, in their own way of course. One of these people was Bikram Choudhury, who made a form of hot yoga that made him famous, and eventually got him into trouble with the law. Allow us to show you Bikram Choudhury, then and now. Be sure to like the video and subscribe to the channel. The early life of Bikram. So, how did a man go from being a yoga instructor to a wanted criminal and on the run from the law? Well, it was a lot of things, but as in all stories, let's start at the beginning, okay? Bikram Choudhury was born in Calcutta, British India, in 1944. He claimed to have begun studying yoga under Bishnu Charan Ghosh and to have won the National India Yoga Championship for 3 consecutive years in his teens. However, the first ever yoga competition in India took place in 1974, long after he had left the country. Recent evidence from interviews for the podcast series 30 for 30 on Choudhury and from Jerome Armstrong's book, Calcutta Yoga, have proven his claims both of early training under Ghosh and of winning the National India Yoga Championships to be false. So, right off the bat, Bikram isn't exactly someone who is trustworthy due to him lying about his credentials in all the ways that matter. But even with that, that doesn't mean that everything he did was a lie, because he really was a yoga guy. Choudhury developed a 26 posture series by piecing together existing sequences from over 500 poses and variations created by Ghosh, and put it into his signature series, which takes about 90 minutes to perform. The 100 degree Fahrenheit, 40 degrees Celsius heat in which Bikram yoga is practiced is, according to Choudhury, meant to mimic the climate of India. Choudhury was closely associated with America's competitive yoga from its inception. The annual Bishnu Charan Ghosh Cup is named for the man he claimed was his teacher. Competitive yoga? Yeah, we know what you're thinking. Wait a minute. Yoga can be competitive? And yeah, apparently it can be. But it's not exactly the most accepted yoga practice in the world. Because more than likely, when you think about yoga, you think about it being a peaceful and stress-free endeavor. True, it can hurt if you do it wrong, but that's more about technique failure versus straining your body to the max like in certain other exercise practices. And that is where the controversy of competitive yoga comes into play. And that is where the controversy of competitive yoga came into play. Because it was one that dared you to push yourself during yoga and tested out the various yoga practices in a much more intense setting. But that in its very nature is in conflict with the true form of yoga as a whole. So, needless to say, a lot of people didn't like this. But Bikram Choudhury didn't really care about that, because he was slowly setting up his yoga empire. And yes, we just said yoga empire. The guru comes to America. By the year 1971, Bikram had come to America with the goal of growing and expanding his true yoga craft. He developed his own style of yoga as noted, and he set up a place in Los Angeles to go and teach others. This was actually a brilliant move, because even back then, celebrities were very much into doing various practices in order to keep themselves both healthy and in shape. And this is where things get a bit odd, because due to how he handled himself and the way he taught, many of his students treated him with reverence, even considering him a guru and saying how honored they were that he was going to teach them his wisdom. But as time went on and people started to look back at how he handled himself and such, he was pretty much a jerk. He would brag about how much income his yoga empire was giving him, as well as the various celebrities from Hollywood that would go and take lessons from him. And when it came to his students, unlike a person who was teaching a meditative craft, Bikram often berated his students, yelling at them and even insulting the ones who were overweight. A documentary about him was made and released on Netflix in 2019, and a certain critic had this to say about what was shown. Mainly that it visually synthesizes decades of archival footage with first-person testimony and filmed court depositions into a devastating portrait of an abusive narcissist, protected from consequences by his own inflated cult of personality, wealth, and professional power within the niche world of hot yoga. You'd think that this kind of treatment of students would go and prevent him from expanding, right? Wrong. Expansion and copyrights. By the 1990s, Bikram Yoga wasn't just growing, it was expanding at an incredible rate. Bikram Yoga studios were founded in many countries around the world. Choudhury taught celebrities such as the pop singers Madonna and Lady Gaga and the footballer David Beckham, and claimed to have taught yoga to American presidents Richard Nixon, Ronald Reagan, and Bill Clinton. Though whether that is true is debatable, much like Bikram's skill in history. As his fame and empire continued to grow, he decided to try and make a further claim to his art, and stated that the 26 poses he used for his yoga were copyrighted, and that they couldn't be used by anyone. Not the least was a former student who had started his own school using similar techniques. Believe it or not, this grew to such lengths that the official copyright office had to go and release a statement saying that the poses themselves couldn't be copyright. Which, if you think about it, honestly makes sense. How can anyone copyright a pose? Lawsuits. Are we talking about Bikram going and filing lawsuits against others? Oh no, that would be too simple. Rather, we're talking about various people going and filing lawsuits against him for his various crimes against his students. Choudhury has faced lawsuits alleging sexual harassment, assault, racism, and homophobia. By January 2014, five women were suing Bikram Choudhury with allegations including sexual harassment and sexual assault. And that was just the start of the claims as a whole. One of the lawsuits stated that he used his inner circle to seek out students for him to violate. Not cool at all. The cases grew and grew, and Bikram's true character started to show. Thankfully, he lost those cases, and many of the women he hurt were given millions in damages. But fleeing, yeah. Given how things were going against Choudhury, he went and fled to India and later on to Mexico in order to open up more of his yoga classes and thus make more money. At first, this was just seen as him trying to get away from the other lawsuits, but then it became clear that he was literally running away and that he wasn't going to return to the country at all. This was compounded when a judge ordered an arrest warrant for Choudhury because he hadn't paid the damages in one of his lawsuits. As well as finding out that Bikram had gone and moved a lot of his money out of the country in order to try and escape his fate. Which he did, and he didn't. Trapped. 2020 was not the best year for a lot of people, but for Bikram Choudhury, it was certainly a year to forget, because just before the global lockdown happened, he found himself in Mexico and racking up bills at a luxurious hotel. But because he couldn't actually pay those bills due to his assets being seized and sold, he found his passport revoked. Oops. And remember, that was before the pandemic lockdown, so any chance of him using his yoga teachings to try and get out of that predicament was quickly squashed as social distancing became mandatory. Legacy? The irony of Bikram Choudhury is multifaceted, because even with all he has done, people are still going to his classes and using his teachings. It's honestly a bit sad, but he is a man who was found to be a monster and had to literally and figuratively go and pay for his crimes, and for that we should be grateful, as well as hopeful that next time a man like him won't get an empire before being caught. So, what do you think? What do you think of this look at Bikram Choudhury and how his yoga took the world by storm, and how Bikram himself took the world by storm in order to get away from the allegations put against him? Let us know in the comments below. Be sure to subscribe, and we'll see you next time on the channel.